During World War II, the United States put all of its effort into strengthening its air forces, prioritizing the strangest ideas and proposals for fighters that manufacturers could conceive and build within a couple of years. One of the most bizarre examples was the Northrop XP-56 Black Bullet, which ultimately was too innovative to be produced. In the early days of the conflict, the U.S. Air Corps was well aware that potentially unfriendly countries were already flying too fast and too high, not to mention their well-armed and smoothly maneuverable aircraft that totally outclassed every model currently built in the U.S. The need for advanced pursuit aircraft became palpable as air combat exploded in Europe, and Germany showcased its technological superiority. Even the Japanese aircraft were unpaired at the time. The Northrop XP-56 was a unique prototype for a cutting-edge fighter interceptor. Although some problems were expected due to the design's novel qualities, the results were so unsuccessful that the aircraft was never produced. Still, by the early 1940s, the XP-56 was one of the most radical experimental aircraft ever conceived, and it was designed to become the fastest airborne ship to roam the skies. A good idea. On July 17, 1939, the U.S. Army Air Forces launched an unofficial design competition to build superior speed performance aircraft. Assistant Secretary of War Lewis K. Johnson announced a $6 million incentive for advanced pursuit aircraft that could be deployed to serve in a couple years, a radical approach at the time. Northrop Corporation founder Jack K. Northrop had considered the idea for an all-wing airframe for a decade already. The company currently had a model designed around the Pratt & Whitney liquid-cooled X-1800 engine. It was built in a pusher configuration, with coaxial three-blade contra-rotating propellers to minimize the torque effect. Northrop submitted this N2B model to the Army and was awarded a fixed-price contract to build a prototype on September 26, 1940. Other contracts were also issued for the Vultee's Swoosh Goose and the Curtiss's XP-55 Ascender. Ultimately, the X-1800 engine production was canceled shortly after that, and the engineers had to adjust their plans. The prototype was delayed by 5 months, and the X-1800 was replaced with the Pratt & Whitney R-2800 double-wasp twin-row 18-cylinder air-cooled radial engine. This engine model was more potent than the X-1800 by 200 horsepower, but it was also considerably heavier and larger. The R-2800 was not the most suitable engine for a pusher configuration, and it accounted for a 2,000-pound increase in weight, resulting in a much slower aircraft. The prototype was nicknamed Black Bullet for unclear reasons, but a plausible explanation might be the bullet-like shape of its rounded nose. The prototype's design also proved too innovative for the era. Its near all-wing airframe had a small vertical tail instead of a horizontal one, which was considered too risky. The aft-mounted dorsal and ventral tails helped the directional stability, and the yaw was controlled by a rudder in the ventral tail. Its wing held a small rounded fuselage that housed the engine and a single seat. The enclosed, unpressurized cockpit was right beside the motor, making it difficult to bail out. Also, its odd configuration was projected to be a swift wing, but materialized as a bulbous fuselage. In addition to its experimental engine, the pusher power plant installation was expected to reduce forebody drag and provide better visibility, and its nose area was free to mount weaponry. Overall, the design sought to maximize thrust and minimize weight, but the airframe was never as fast as expected and had no direction. Moreover, an aluminum shortage forced the designers to experiment with unproved metals. They eventually used a magnesium alloy that was not easily welded with conventional techniques. For this reason, Northrop brought in designer Vladimir Pobletchka, who developed heliarc welding. The company would later patent a special welding torch. The knowledge acquired around the new metals was perhaps the most important legacy the XP-56 project eventually left behind. Risky trials. Since the XP-56 design was considered too risky, a smaller, lightweight aircraft of similar configuration was built. The N1M multi-bomber was mounted with two Lycoming engines, and successful tryouts confirmed the basic layout was functional. The results were encouraging, and while the first prototype was still being built, the Army ordered a second one on February 13, 1942. By March of 1943, the first XP-56 was ready to perform engine runs. The bare metal all-silver aircraft showed excessive propeller shaft flex, and the engine failed. Pratt & Whitney then sent another engine that took 5 months to arrive. When taxi tests were carried out, serious yaw issues arose, as well as a significant problem with uneven wheel brakes. Efforts were made to fix them with manual hydraulic brakes, and the upper fin had to be enlarged to almost match the ventral unit area. Further tests by September did not prove particularly encouraging. The inaugural flight lasted only 30 seconds, 5 feet above the ground, and at a top speed of 130 miles per hour. a severe nose-down pitch tendency and lateral directional sensitivities turned up. A second flight showed a multi-axis control problem, and its landing was basically a controlled crash. Several disappointing test flights followed, but the worst one took place on October 8, 1943. John Myers piloted several radical designs by Northrop during the war. While performing a high-speed taxi in Rogers Dry Lake, Morocco, a tire blew out, somersaulting the vehicle 2.5 times. Myers was catapulted out through the canopy and survived with minor injuries, crediting his polo player's helmet with saving him. The aircraft was almost completely wrecked. Myers would later state that, quote, "The airplane wanted to fly upside down and backwards, and finally did." A second chance. The Black Bullet's second prototype was completed in January of 1944. This new model was enhanced with several improvements. Its center of gravity was reballasted, and its upper vertical stabilizer size was increased. Also, the rudder control linkages were reworked to improve the yaw tendencies, implementing a wingtip yaw control system with blown air jets for steering. This new gray and green camouflage model was given cantilever mid-wing elevons, which would operate as ailerons as well as wing flaps. Also, there were air ducts for engine cooling on the wing's leading edge and air intakes for its control system. After numerous modifications, the final design ended up with a 42-foot 6-inch wingspan and featured a 32-degree leading edge sweep. Although the service ceiling reached 33,000 feet, its maximum speed was 465 miles per hour at 25,000 feet. The advanced airframe layout placed the pilot directly behind the weaponry, which was planned to carry 2 20-millimeter cannons and 4 50-caliber machine guns. However, they were never fitted into either aircraft. The second prototype was first flown in March by pilot Harry Crosby at the Northrop Field. The aircraft performed 10 flights in the span of 5 months. Crosby also found the aircraft tough to handle. The pilot had many difficulties trying to lift the nose below 160 miles per hour, and the rudder sensitivity was still too extreme. This time, the aircraft flew for less than 8 minutes, but the top speed increased to 250 miles per hour. When the landing gear was retracted, the aircraft stalled and Crosby had to extend it to regain control. He then adjusted the trim and tried again, finding more stability. However, the severe vibration dissuaded him from exceeding 250 miles per hour, the fastest the Black Bullet ever flew. Fantasy meets reality. In the last testing stage, the Black Bullet showed no significant improvements, but the engineers were puzzled and could not pin down its main issues. The National Advisory Committee for Aeronautics would have to get involved and analyze how to reach the desired speeds, but that would involve further testing. After the 10th flight, the XP-56 showed significant tail heaviness, insufficient power, and excessive fuel consumption. Tests in the wind tunnel were planned for May 1944, but the prototype was not deemed airworthy. By 1946, new jet-powered technology was emerging, and there was no further need for propeller fighters. Flying the Black Bullet had proven unsafe, and the project was ultimately abandoned after a year of inactivity. Still, the project wasn't a complete waste. The Black Bullet was the first flying wing ever tested by the U.S. Army, and the first of many flying wings designed at the Northrop facility in Hawthorne, California. Furthermore, all the knowledge obtained was applied to future aircraft, such as the XB-35 bomber built in 1946. The surviving prototype can be seen at the Smithsonian Institution's National Air and Space Museum in Washington, D.C., stored and unrestored, never having met its true potential.